Jal Kumar Sen, and in this video tutorial I am going to share with you how to find out life of bearing. Okay, so basically you know, these tutorials are only for gate point of view, or if you wanted to solve numerical problems. So numericals point of view, I am sharing these days all videos. I am not going to share you what is bearing, even types of bearing. Of course, there are many types of bearing, just like rolling contact bearing and sliding contact bearing. Okay, so these are all types of bearing. But here in this video tutorial, I am going to share with you only about life of bearing and how you can solve numerical problems. So good news for you. In this tutorial, I am going to share with you two numerical problems, those already asked in GATE previous year examination. That's why you will have approach to solve numerical problems too, related to GATE examination, right? So what is the formula? First of all, if you have any one of my video tutorial, then probably you know the way of my teaching style. First of all, I will let you introduce to the formula. What is the formula for finding out life of bearing? That is L is equal to let's say C by F whole to the power, let's say N, 10 to the power 6 revolution. Okay, so this is the formula for finding out life of bearing. Okay, but life of bearing may be given in hours also, so in that case we'll consider this one on revolution, we'll not consider. Okay, so I will share with you how to find out life in that case, because one of the numerical problem we have right now I'm sharing with you, and that problem already has in GATE previous year. So here we'll go for the each and everything what they have given in this formula. So what is basically L is life of bearing, that's it. What is C is dynamic load capacity. So L is life of bearing. What is C? Dynamic load capacity. And what is F? F is equivalent dynamic load. And what is N? Well, N is depend on the bearing number. So bearing number would be consist of four numbers, let's say A, B, C, D. So the second one is N. Remember that the second one is N. I will also share with you the already they have asked question and they have given the bearing number. So it's a designation of number for ball bearing. Okay, so you can say it's a designation, how to find out things, what are things given in the bearing. So it's a designation of you can say ball bearing, right? So N is what? N is depend on types of bearing. So if you are saying ball bearing, in case of ball bearing N is 3, and in case of roller bearing, if you're talking about roller bearing, so it's 10 by 3. So if in GATE they have asked always, I have seen two questions previous year, they have asked ball bearing. So if they will ask roller bearing, then you have to use 10 by 3 in place of N. So it is not a problem for you, because you will have calculated to for calculation, right? So this is all about the formula, and this is all about things in the formula. Okay, so now what we'll do, we'll go for the question, those question already asked in GATE previous year. That's why you can do much better in the examination, right? So let's go for the question, right? So we have given the question, and this question already asked in GATE 2007 for 1 mark, and you can easily solve the question once you will understand that formula and grab the concept. So let's read the question first. So in this question they have asked a ball bearing. Okay, that's cool. A ball bearing, that means we can write N is equal to 3. Okay, now look. At load F has 8000 hours life. It state that it is having 8000 hours life. Cool. That's cool. Now, if it is having 8000 hours life, that means L is equal to this. Life of bearing in hours, they said this is a case 1. Okay, case 1, L1. So, life of the bearing case 2. Suppose that this is 2K, second case, this is first case. What is the life of the bearing when load is? So, case 1 load is F. Case 2 load is 2F. So, they said that what is the load of the bearing if load is 2F, right? So, what they have given, basically they have given only 3 data, L1, N and of course these 2. Now, according to the formula, what is the formula for finding out life of bearing? We'll go to the formula because that is the most basic formula to find out anything related to life of bearing. According, I mean, there are 3 important components we have given, like, and 4, because we can also find out what type of bearing we have. Okay, so let's go for that formula. L is equal to C by F whole to the power N multiple 10 to the power 6. So just we have 2 cases. So if I will not consider even this 10 to the power 6, it's okay, because in case second even we will not consider this 10 to the power 6. In this way, what will happen? The calculation will decrease. That's why I'm not considering this 10 to the power 6. Got it? Now let's go for is L1 is equal to 8000. We know that. We don't know C, but we know that F is this, and we know N is equal to 3. So what we can say, let's say C1 F1. So C1 by F1, what is the C1 by F1? So C1 by F1 is equal to 8000 whole to the power 1 by 3. So what we can say, C1 is equal to F1. So let's find out, it's 8000, it's 20, I think, right? Yeah, so it's 20, and as you know, what is C, I have already shared with you, dynamic load capacity, that is also load, that means force. So its unit would be in Newton. I can say that, right? Now let's go for that, which one is also important for us. Ooh, what is that? Yes, that is the important thing, right? So what is that basically? That is case 2. We have to go to that case 2. We have to find out L. We have find out already F1 20C. Okay, so F2 would be 2F1. Okay, and root 3, right? Now from this, this one get cancelled. F1 2 multiple 10 is 20. So 10 to the power 3, that means 1000 hours is the answer for this question. That means, now let's look at the option. Yeah, option A is the right answer for this question. That means if there would be double in force, or F is equivalent load, you can say equivalent dynamic load, then there will be decrease in life, will be decrease. That means life will decrease, and we got the answer is what? 1000. Yeah, you can see 1000 hours, right? So this is the first question. Let's move for the next question. In the second question we have right now here. Now, as I have talking about, let's say designation of the bearing A, B, C, D. From B, we can say what is N. N is equal to what? 3. So, if N is equal to 3, that means what type of bearing we have? Ball bearing. If N is equal to 3, then what type of bearing we have? Ball bearing. Right. So, now, let's go for it. Dynamic load capacity. I have shared with you what is dynamic load. That is C is equal to 22 kilonewton. That means 22 multiple 10 to the power 3 newton. Always try to convert all things into newton if they have S in SI, right? So, but they have S in kilonewton, so we can convert it later also. No big deal, right? So what we got here, N is equal to how much? C is equal to how much? Now, maximum radial load it can sustain. That means we have to find out F, equivalent load capacity. That is F. F is what? At 600 revolution per minute for 200 hours. It's 200 hours or 2000 hours? I think it's 2000. Yeah, it's 2000 hours, right? So we have to find out what? We have to find out F if this value. So we can find out what is L from here. 600 multiple 2 thousand and hours. If you convert hours into minutes, I have to multiply with 60. So 600, that means 70. It's a 600, 2000, 600, 2000 multiple 60. So it's 7 to 10 to the power 6. It's revolution now. It's revolution, right? So we know that formula for finding out life. Life of bearing C is L is equal to C by F whole to the power N 10 to the power 6. Now what we have to find out F, we have given all things. Now 72 multiple 10 to the power 6, we have given C. 22 multiple 10 to the power 3, F is not given. 3, this is 3, 10 to the power 6. This one get cancelled. Now I can send this 3 to this side. This will become cube root. So 72 1 by 3 is equal to 22 10 to the power 3 by F. Now this send this F to this side and this one to this side. So what we got basically after simplification of this equation, 22 multiple 3 10 to the power 3, 72 1 by 3 is equal to what? Let's get it here. 22 multiple 10 to the power 3 divided 72 1 by 3. So what we got basically, it's 5288.24. If you divide by 1000, because it's given in kilonewton, so 5.28 kilonewton we got it, right? So F is equal to what? 5.288 is there. So 5.29 we can say 29 kilonewton. So answer is exactly matching with option C. Got it? So this is how we can solve question related to bearing. But this is a case of, you know, we have gone through only ball bearing only. Okay, so ball bearing we have done. Now we can go for this is also known as this ball bearing also known as a rolling contact bearing, you can say this, right? Now we'll go for the sliding contact bearing if you'll have question related to it. I hope you understand the concept, I hope you understand the formula, I hope you understand, and not hope, you can easily understand because it's really simple. Okay, so thanks for watching. If you have any question related to this topic, you can comment below, you can contact me on Facebook also, and if you like the tutorial, share with your friends. That's why they will also get help from this video tutorial. Thanks for watching. Thank you very much for being on my YouTube channel. Bye bye.